Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, and I'm talking about evaluating exponential expressions today. Expressions do not have equal signs. We're not going to solve and find out what the variable is. We're given a value for the variable and say, well, if it does equal this, what would you get? I want to remind you a couple things. X to the y power, in this expression, x is the base and y is the exponent. So when you're looking at these expressions here, identify the base and identify the exponent. You should try these on your own. This is a really important thing, and you need to be able to do that on your own. The base in this problem is negative 4. Because the parentheses are around it, we actually have a base of negative 4, and the power you probably got right of 2. In the second problem, we have a different thing because I will tell you the exponent you probably got was 4. But what's the base? Well, the base is not negative 5 because we don't have parentheses around it. The power can only affect what it touches directly. So the base is just 5. This looks like negative 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. Negative 625, because that negative doesn't repeat. It's just one time out in front. This one looks like negative 4 times negative 4, which is positive 16. That negative does repeat. What about this problem? What's the base and what's the exponent? Well, the base, exponent is 3. That's always the easy one. But what's the base? The base is what the exponent is touching. In this case, it's just the x. The negative 3 out front has nothing to do with our base. So it's important to be able to identify your base and your exponent as you move through those problems. Evaluate the expression. Now we're going to have some expressions that have exponents in them, and we have to evaluate them by substituting in. Now, we've kind of talked about this and done some of this in the past. So if I know that y equals negative 3, this says whatever y is, that whole thing goes to the second power. Since y is negative 3, I want to make sure I put parentheses around it when I substitute it in. If you always put parentheses around what you substitute in, it will never steer you wrong. Sometimes you need them, sometimes you don't. It never hurts to have them. So put them on there, because you might leave them off and it changes the value, right? Now this says negative 3 times negative 3, and that is positive 9. When you put that into your calculator, if you just put negative 3 squared and don't put parentheses around it, the calculator is going to tell you that's negative 9, because it's thinking that you have something like number 2 where the base is 3. If you want it to give you the correct answer, you need to put parentheses around it to show that you had a y that was negative 3. The whole y was negative 3, and that's positive 9. Okay, the second one, or number 5 in our progression here, we have 3. This means times, even though we don't see it. We have 3 times x, which is negative 1. So I'm going to put parentheses so it doesn't look like 3 minus 1. And then we have y to the third power, and our y is 2. So y is just 2, so that's going to look like 2 to the third power. So by plugging those in and putting parentheses around, it should be clear to you that we need to do the exponent first and then the multiplication. So I'm going to do the exponent first. 2 to the third power is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. I can put parentheses around that to show multiplication, or I could have used a dot like I did here. And now if I multiply that, 3 times negative 1 is negative 3, and negative 3 times 8 is negative 24. So we simplified using the order of operations, but first we had to plug those in correctly, and that's an important thing to remember. Okay, two more. What about number 6? We have 3a to the 4th power over 7, and we know that a is negative 2. Since the whole a, just like on number 4 there, the whole a is negative 2. So when I plug that in, I want to make sure and put parentheses around it. I have negative 2 to the 4th power over 7, like that. We're going to simplify the numerator first, and in the numerator we have an exponent, we have multiply. Negative 2 to the 4th power is negative 2, 4 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2, and that's 4 negatives. That's an even number, so it's going to be positive 16. And now we're going to do 3 times 16, which is 48. And 48 over 7, it's not an exact number, so I'm going to leave it as an improper fraction. It's great when we get an integer or a whole number, but if we don't want to change everything into decimals and mixed numbers. Leave it. Simplified form means there's no common factors between the top and the bottom, and there is not here. Number 7, there's a negative out front in p squared. The base in this problem is p. That negative has nothing to do with that power. It's just hanging around out front. We could think of it as negative 1 times p squared. That would be the same thing, right? We don't show the 1, but it's just a negative that has nothing to do with the power. So I'm going to say negative, and then instead of p, I'm going to put parentheses around what p was, which is 6 to the second power. Notice that that negative is out front, and so I have negative 6 times 6. That negative did not repeat. There's just one. That makes it a negative overall, and I get negative 36. So that is evaluating an expression that contains exponents. Have a fantastic day. We'll see you next.